never had a problem. I had a little chihuahua with me. We were in the field, boom, and all of a sudden, this dude asked me a question, so I was across the street with this fat guy, and then he was asking me when I'm gonna breed my dog, and I says, I'm gonna just give me a second, and I'll wait till I get off house arrest and see what I'm gonna do, then I'll let you know. As soon as that happened, I looked across the street, and I seen Buddy running with his girlfriend or whatever, maybe it was another American girl or whatever. She was running down the sidewalk with the dog with a black lab, you know, and my dog seen it. It stopped for a second. I was like maybe from here, like my dog was right there, maybe where the guy's at. And I seen him looking at something, so I was like, damn. So when I looked across the street, I seen him coming. I was like, oh shit. And then as soon as my dog seen him running with it, it caught his eye and he darted for him, and I was starting running back after him. So he was attacking the dog. This dude was kicking and punching my dog in the face and shit. Bam, bam. Lucky I didn't do nothing to the buddy though. You know what I'm saying? So I got mad at my dog because my dog almost knows me. That's why he got scared, because he shouldn't have did that. You know what I'm saying? And my dog never did that before. So I was like, yo, what the hell you doing? As soon as I ran up on him, I says, whoa, what the hell you doing? And he backed up. So I grabbed him and I put my leash on him. I said, buddy, you all right? He got up and ran away, scared, hauling ass home. And then I took my dog home. All of a sudden, some dude came rolling around, asked if I had a white pit bull. I said, nah, it's an American bulldog, which I think was his pop. I says, nah, man, this would happen. You know, I'm right here. This is where I stay. I ain't running. I ain't, you know, it just was a freak accident. This is what happened. I just feel my dog shouldn't be declared dangerous. I have to pay so much money because I can't afford that. I'm on disability, right? Well, not disability. I'm on workman's comp. My tendons got cut by a piece of glass. So he don't know nothing about tendons. I can't feel nothing on this right hand of my hand. So, you know, and then I got hit in the head. So that's why I'm disabled. They took another one out of my legs, and I can't feel like this leg too. So you don't know nothing about tendons on that. See what I'm saying? I'm allowed to walk my dog only with my left hand. See what I'm saying? I'm always with my left, never with my right. They can all box for that. You know, it was just a freak accident. He was coming up the street, and my dog seen him when he was running up with the dog. My dog seen him, and that's it. My dog just died for him. He never did that before. I'm not saying, but I don't have the money to pay for that. I can pay probably in payments, but I don't have no money like that, because I only get like a little bit of workman's comp, which ain't nothing right now. My mom helps me with the rest. She can vouch for that. And that's it. I'm married and I got two kids, and that's it. That's what happened. I understand I'd be liable, but I shouldn't feel that my dog should be taken away from me, or it should be dangerous if this is only happened one time. See what I'm saying? From now on, I will never leave him off the leash, and I will never ever let him go. That's it. I hold him, I walk him, and I will never let him off the leash no more. I work outside of him. I could pay like $50 or something in the morning. I don't know what if I couldn't afford, you know, to take care of whatever happened to the body and the dog. But I seem to feel that my dog should be, you know, taken from me, or say he's a dangerous dog, but he ain't dangerous. He's a lovable dog.
How do you explain the injuries to the shooter?
Well, you know, he's an American. They just rough dog, man. It's a terrier. You know, all terriers are like that, man. They just got that's all. They just got a strong jaw. That's it. And you know, that's all. Like, he's not a fighter. He don't fight. I got two other females in the house. He don't fight with them. He just one time, I don't know what got into him, and he felt spunky, and he just reacted. That's it. I can't tell you why he reacted.
What was he reacting to, sir?
Now, I don't know. He was just running and he caught his eye, and the dog ran after it. That's all that happened.
It's an unfortunate situation.
My dog was attacking him, so he was punching it and kicking it. By the time I'm running to get there to get my dog off, the dog did. So they've been fighting for a minute. Of course that's going to happen, you understand? I feel sorry for him, and I apologize. I said, yo, dude, it was an accident. Before I can even say that, he was down the block already.
With his dog?
Running away with his dog, yes.
You think it is because he was injured, the dog was injured, and he felt he needed attention for it?
Yeah, I don't know what was the fact, but I was trying to see if he was all right, too. I was like, you all right? But he kept just running anyways. You know what I'm saying?
All right. Anything else, Mr. Rivera?
No.
Do you have any other witnesses? Anybody else want to say anything? You know, we're here on an ordinance from the 2004 edition 01, that part two dangerous dog.